In this video, a man comes and stands in an empty room, as you can see, and he starts speaking.
I'm in the reverberation chamber.
But his voice is not clearly understandable. Why do you think it is so? When a person is inside a room and he or she is speaking, the sound is traveling from the person's mouth and it is hitting the wall in front. After hitting the wall, as you will recall we studied earlier, it bounces back and is reflected and reaches the person's ears. Now this sound reaches the person's ears and it also hits the walls that is behind the person. The same sound after reflection from the walls behind reaches the person's ears. Now this sound also reaches the ceiling, hits the ceiling and reaches the person's ears. The same sound again hits the floors, bounces back off the floors and takes multiple reflections and reaches the person's ears. So what can we say? When a person is in a room and he or she speaks, sound reaches the person's ears after multiple reflections, that is after getting reflected repeatedly. So, what do you think happens in that case? Let us take a look at this video to clearly illustrate the concept of reflected sound and direct sound. In this video, we have taken two guns. Gun 1 fires a disc which reaches the target directly, and gun 2 fires a disc which first hits the wall, gets reflected, and then hits the target. So let us see what happens when both the guns fire the discs at the same time. You will find that the disc that is fired from gun 1 reaches the target first, and the disc fired from gun 2, which first hits the wall and then the target, reaches the target later. Now notice that both the discs were fired at the same time, but the disc from gun 1 reached the target before the disc from gun 2. This is because disc 1 traveled a lesser distance as compared to disc 2. And a similar thing happens in case of sound as well. If we consider direct sound and reflected sound, direct sound always reaches our ears first because it travels a lesser distance as compared to reflected sound, which travels a longer distance. Reflected sound travels a longer distance than direct sound. Now, in a small closed room, we cannot hear an echo. Now, I just mentioned that in a closed room, there are repeated reflections, and we had also learned that due to reflection, we can hear echo. So why can we not hear echo in a small closed room? Because, as you will recall, for our ears to distinguish between two sounds, there should be a time gap of 0.1 seconds between the sound and reflection. That is, there should be a lag of 0.1 seconds. So that is the reason why we are not able to hear an echo inside a small closed room, because the time gap between the sound and the reflections is much less than 0.1 seconds. Now consider a small room of around 5.5 meters in length and breadth. You will be surprised to learn that in such a room, if we consider one angle, sound bounces off the walls around 60 times in just 1 second, as you can see from this video. And this is just shown from one angle. Consider how many more angles must be there inside a room. So let us look at the entire thing objectively. So what is happening when sound is getting reflected and it is reaching our ears? In a closed room, the reflected sound is reaching our ears in a time that is less than 0.1 seconds. So this sound that we are speaking is getting reflected many times, that is multiple reflections are taking place, and these multiple reflections are arriving to us in a very short span of time. So there is a continuous stream of sound energy that we are hearing the moment we speak due to these multiple reflections. This leads to a continuous stream of sound. This continuous stream of sound fuses or comes together and becomes a single entity or a single sound. And it is due to this reason that the sound seems to last longer. That is, in an empty room, if I say hello, it will seem to sound like hello. So what is this phenomenon called? The persistence of sound due to repeated reflections from the walls, ceilings, and the floor is known as reverberation. Reverberation is the phenomenon due to which we are able to hear a sound, hear the persistence of sound due to repeated reflections. So you must be wondering that why you are not being able to hear reverberations in your room, in your bedroom or your dining room. Now, in your bedroom or in any other room in your house, you must be having furnitures like chairs and tables and curtains and beds. The presence of these objects acts as absorbers and diffusers of sound. Now, what are absorbers and diffusers? If an object is an absorber of sound, it does not allow the sound to get reflected back after sound hits the object. And what are diffusers of sound? Diffusers of sound are those objects after which sound hits them is scattered in an even direction around the room. So due to the presence of such objects in your room, you are not able to hear the reverberation in your room. Now, why do you think reverberation is bad? Let us see a small video and find out. Here you will notice that a combination of absorbers and diffusers have been used to prevent reverberation. You will notice that when absorbers and diffusers are not there, the sound seems to persist longer. And when they are there, the sound is not persisting. Now, if you are in your movie hall watching your favorite movie and the hero's dialogue is overlapping, won't it be very bad? Won't it sound very bad? Now, I have been talking all about the ill effects of reverberation. But do you think reverberation is always bad? Such is not the case. In a concert hall, when a singer is singing or an orchestra is performing, it is required that there should be a certain amount of reverberation present. Why do you think that is so? Because when the singer is singing or the orchestra is performing, it is required that the sound is distinctly heard by every person present in the auditorium. And this can be achieved if the sound persists for a longer period of time. And this persistence of sound, as we just studied, is known as reverberation. So, it is preferred that in concert halls, reverberation to a certain extent is present. So let us take a quick recap of what we learned. We learned that in a room, if a person speaks, the sound is reflected multiple times off the walls, the floor, and the ceiling, and it reaches the person's ears. It is due to these multiple reflections that the sound seems to persist for a long time. This persistence of sound for a long period of time is known as reverberation. So what happens when reverberation occurs, let's say when you're watching a movie? If reverberation takes place when you're watching a movie, the dialogues are going to overlap one over the other, and you will not be able to understand when your favorite hero says your favorite dialogue. But reverberation is not always bad. Reverberation is sometimes preferred in concert halls where singers sing and an orchestra performs. Why? Because in such cases, it is required that the sound persists for some amount of time so that every person present in the auditorium is able to hear the sound clearly and distinctly.